Hello, everyone. Welcome to the Gossip Corner podcast. I am your host, Greg Burlinghouse.
And I'm Paul Burlinghouse.
Today, this also kind of doubles in a way as the Genetics podcast, which is a podcast I do with my cousin, Sam.
No.
Because
no.
Our two special guests are two of my cousins.
This is such a lie. No, Gossip Corner is mostly ran by Paul Burlinghouse.
No, yeah, I agree.
But yeah.
This is also similar to a podcast.
No. Not the same.
Well, I'd like to introduce my two guests, that are related to us.
Kind of.
Two cousins, Bobby Burlinghouse and Gabby Burlinghouse.
Well, have them say their names. Don't be like...
Hey, guys.
No.
Hi.
Hey, how are you?
Okay, no.
I am German.
Bobby is not German, and he is...
He is Puerto Rican.
How old are you, Bobby? You're in... 8th grade.
I'm 12. I've been hostage for 5 years.
7th?
7th.
Yes. Yeah,
Gabby, you're in 5th grade, correct?
I think.
Yeah, so we...
She thinks.
It's nice to get a younger perspective on today's entertainment news, and I think this is going to be an interesting time, so let's dig in.
Just talk about, like...
Mac Miller, rest in peace.
Macklemore, rip Macklemore.
All right.
Rip Sam Smith.
What are you guys' thoughts? Do you think Ariana Grande is at fault?
I just, like... First of all, when I saw his photo, I was like, oh my god, I didn't know Sam Smith died because he looks like Sam Smith.
LOL. I think people are, you know, blaming Ariana Grande for...
And that's so
that's
weird.
Ridiculous.
Why would you do
that?
That
is absolutely ridiculous.
Totally.
She left him because, like, he was a mess. Like,
yeah,
why would you... Don't blame her.
Okay, well...
Okay, I like Macklemore.
I'm not the biggest fan of Ariana Grande, but still, you know, it's just...
She doesn't deserve that.
She should not be blamed for that. She had nothing to do with it.
I mean, she is dating Pete Davidson, who has butthole eyes, but whatever.
Yeah, and looks like an owl.
Hey, whoa, guys.
whoa. Wait. Still more on Ariana. So, basically, she was like, She was defending Pete on, like, the Manchester bombing jokes that he made.
Uh-oh.
But one person made a joke about his butthole eyes, and she, like, flipped out on them, which is, like, shut up. Like, dummy. Oh, my God. Anyways, keep going.
This is breaking news, at least for me. I just learned about this. Eminem just came out with a diss track response to MGK's diss track.
I heard he mentions Lil Tay in it.
You've heard it?
No, but I've just heard
about
it.
We're going to hear it right now.
Oh, really?
Gabby, this might be a little explicit for your ears.
Watch your profanity.
Well, yes. So, good reference, Bobby.
No. Can I do like a quick recap of like
World War II
of Machine Gun Kelly's diss? Basically,
seriously, Bobby.
Basically, the first diss that, like, he made, like, the first line on it is, "Get me some clippers, your beard is weird." So, that's just, like, his response.
This track was not good.
It was really bad. It was god-awful.
Not a fan of MGK, just not a fan.
It was so bad. Like, really making fun of someone's beard? Ooh, you got him. Anyways, keep going.
And Eminem, you know, he hasn't had a good album in a while, in my opinion, but I still think he's good, you know?
He's got likable rapper.
That's not true, but...
Other than Macklemore, but he just died, so...
I guess there used to be two, but...
Yeah.
Alright, so... Here we go. This is titled Kill Shot.
Oh.
Here we go.
Doing this once.
The beard is weird.
Ariana just hit me on a text. Last night I left hickeys on her neck. Wait, you just dissed me? I'm perplexed. Insult me in a line, compliment me on the next. Damn, I'm really sorry you want me to have a heart attack. Was watching 8 Mile on my Nauta track. Realized I forgot to call you back. Here's that autograph for your daughter. I wrote it on a starter cap. Stand, son, listen, man, dad isn't mad, but how you gonna name yourself after a damn gun and have a man bun?
Oh,
man, that wasn't that good. This is just white on white crime. This is like.
It's just like white chocolate.
How can you call yourself after a gun, but then have a man bun? Wow, he got him.
And I'm still outselling you. By 29, I had 3 albums that it blew. Now let's talk about something I don't really do. Going someone's daughter's mouth stealing food. But you're a fucking molehill. Now I'll make a mountain out of you. Oh, chill, acting like you put the chrome barrel to my bone marrow.
Skip around a little.
Street albums ago. What do you know? Oops. Brave, got to get your own way. I'm the labor date of this. Fucking machine gun. Who's on the right?
All right. Well, okay. Well,
that was just white on white crime. That wasn't anything.
Although it was much better than,
I guess, yeah, but I, not that much better.
Yeah, it was like
Cardi B's ghostwriter could write something better than that.
It's like fighting garbage.
Anyways, garbage. Right, well, that's a good segue. That's a good segue.
Pause, anything?
This is like the main event of the entire podcast. This is the reason why.
Okay.
Let me say. So, at New York Fashion Week, which I don't even know what was a thing, but whatever. It's like this really high classy event that all these people go to. It's like the Met Gala, but like not as good. So basically, both Nicki and Cardi were there, and for like I think Cardi had the. I think she had, like, the idea that people around her were telling her that Cardi was, like, talking trash about her child, calling her a bad mother, just something, like, stupid like that, and everyone was, like, lying about that. So, Cardi B threw her shoe at Nicki at the place, like, in a high-profile place, like, there was cameras everywhere, like, everyone saw it, and she was, like, I don't know, she was, like, Get over here. And then you can just hear Nicki in, like, the background going, I'm staying right here. Oh, my God. What an icon. So, yeah, Cardi was, like, trying to fight her. And then on Instagram, she responded to, like, the whole thing just to recap it. And she's like, I can't believe someone would talk trash about my child. And then, like, 3 days after the whole thing happened, like, this was, like, it's, like, yeah. So Nicki responds on her, like, radio show, and, like, she's so, like, unbothered by it, you can tell, like, she obviously doesn't care, because it's, like, not a big deal, what's Cardi gonna do? She's worth $4 million, and Nicki's, like, worth $70 million, so it's, like, anyways, so she was, like, Onika Minaj has never talked ill of anyone's child, and anyone who's telling you that is a complete liar, and then she said something about, like, how, Cardi B's publicist said something about how Nicki's working hard to make Cardi not secure her bag, which means, like, making sure that Cardi doesn't get money and people don't stream her music, which is so stupid because Nicki doesn't do that kind of stuff. But, yeah, so, Nicki was like, how can you say that, like, you support black women and you're all about this stuff, but then you call women who are darker than you roaches, and then you call all this stuff, and you say all this stupid things, and you're also, like, racist to all other races. Like, it, like, she's such a trash person, and, like, everyone, like, she's now just getting exposed for that, and it's just iconic. Anyways, yeah.
So why did they fight?
Well, because I feel like it's because the media and everyone around them keeps comparing them to each other, which you shouldn't do, because, like...
Agreed.
Like, yeah. Oh, you see two black females, oh, let's compare them, because whatever. But, like, that's so weird. Why would you do that? Like, you don't compare, like...
What team are you on?
What?
Oh, Nicki, duh.
Nicki, oh, interesting.
Oh, so
you're... Why is that?
Because... Nicki didn't throw back. She didn't fight back. She stayed classy. Honorable. And she was an adult about it. Cardi just threw a shoe at her. And was like, come at me! Like, calm down.
Now, you were talking for a while. It was hard for me to listen.
Mm-hmm.
Was Nicki talking bad about Cardi's child?
Well.
Oh, not so honorable then, huh?
No, Nicki. Well, rumors around.
Oh, rumors.
Oh, rumors.
Well, Cardi was just told by everyone around her that basically. Oh my god, I have so many things to say. Oh my
god. Why are they trying to start some.
Are they black?
Because here's the thing. Atlantic Records, that, like, record label, they do not like Nicki. And they tried to pay Cupcake, you know, that rapper, Cupcake. They tried to pay her to have beef with Nicki.
Oh,
She said on, Cupcake said on Twitter that, they offered her, like, $200,000 to have beef with Nicki. And then
that makes sense. That's I bet a lot of rap beefs are.
And then Cupcake was like, "No, can you not?" And then Cupcake was like, "And then Cupcake was like, oh no, like that's so stupid. I can make that money by myself."
So yeah, that is baller. Anyways, back to that. Good for Cupcake.
So what I'm thinking, is everyone wants this beef to happen because it causes a lot more music and a lot more money to go back into the industry.
Agreed.
So in the end, it does help the industry, but it's also, like, a stupid and, like, unclassy, childish way to, like, handle things and, like, lie to people.
I completely agree, Paul.
And, like, it's just, like, people were... I feel like there was just so much miscommunication between the two because, you know, Nicki doesn't talk about anyone because, like, she just... She's, like, unbothered by everyone.
I respect that.
And I bet you, like, you know, the Migos, Quavo, like, they probably are being paid by other records to, like, cause this fake beef between them. Because, like, that's so, like, that's what happened on Motorsport. Because there was this whole, like, beef on the song Motorsport because Nicki apparently dissed Cardi, but she didn't. And Migos told Cardi that she did, and it was just, like, so many lies, and it was all from Migos, like, it was all them. Yeah, so I feel like everyone who was listening is now gone now, so...
Ooh.
Oh, no, because I was talking for so long. Anyway.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Okay, yeah, that's what I have to say.
Come on. There you go. Very... well thought.
Unique thoughts.
So any entertainment news you guys have had on your mind that you've wanted to get out of your chest?
No.
Why is that? Have you not been keeping up to date?
Paul, wait, I don't have your chance.
Let them talk.
Yeah, I don't want to talk. I just realized, I don't want
to.
If they don't have anything.
I don't have anything.
Like to talk about global warming.
We don't talk about
hurricane.
That's not real, so.
No, Florence. Bobby. No, please, Bobby, no.
Hurricane Florence doesn't even exist. Calm down.
So, okay, Paul, what was your other thing?
I think I heard about this, but they're, like, making a documentary on Jake Paul.
Oh, I did hear about this a little. Shane Dawson's involved, I think, somehow.
I'm nervous because, like, what if it's, like, just, like, propaganda for Team 10 and it's all just about him?
Of course it will be. What do you mean?
It's a documentary called Jake Paul, you idiot.
Because, like...
Whoa, Bobby, whoa.
Because, like, Shane...
Bobby,
like,
you're a little high.
Shut up!
I want to speak up more.
I'm just saying shut up to God. To Bobby.
Can we get along, please?
Shane's
family.
Shane's just, like...
Yay.
He's saying on, like, oh, yeah, I'm gonna expose him. I'm gonna show the entire truth.
Oh, really?
But no, he's not. Like, I just
Why do
know
you think this?
Because I've seen the other documentaries. It's not like he exposes anyone. He's all friends with the people that he makes documentaries about. Tana Mojo, he defended.
Ooh.
He defended her.
Now, who is that?
Jeffree Star, he defended
him. Now, who is that?
Isn't she, like, a trans rich person?
Well, first of all, Tana Mojo was just an idiot who did TanaCon and she scammed, like, thousands of people. Well, not really. She didn't make money off of it, but, like, whatever. And then Jeffree Star's, like, was really racist, like, 12 years ago, but, like, yeah.
Nay.
He made
Passes
jokes
in the past.
He made jokes about throwing battery acid at a black girl
Jesus
to make
Christ.
Her foundation match.
Ooh.
I know.
That's not gonna get the joke.
Yikers.
But the thing is, he's friends with all these people, and he defends all these people. So I'm like, what if he just defends Jake the entire time?
Well, what if he doesn't? You know, I'm fingers
I hope
crossed.
He doesn't. I really hope he doesn't.
Me too.
But
hashtag me too.
That's
hashtag me too, bro.
I love how last episode we were talking about the Me Too movement, and now we're just talking about, like, Jake Paul.
Hey, you know?
That
some episodes will be lighter than others. That is unavoidable.
I think, well, I mean, we do have children in this room.
Yes, we can't get into the nitty gritty. I'm sorry, that's just not gonna happen.
Can't go in the dark. What are you doing?
I'm on Snapchat.
Where am I not allowed to live?
What?
That's deep.
Yeah,
Bobby.
That's...
Wow.
Well, I think we've gone through.
Keep looking. E-news.
Well, I just want to make this easier to upload because it's at 14 minutes. we could just upload this right away easily, you know? You know what I mean?
Yeah.